We're live, we're local, we're CBS 3.
There's a way, way bigger than me, and if I can help, let's do it.
Tonight, a diagnosis of ALS has changed the life of a Minnesota senator, but he's not backing down. Instead, he's standing up for others and continuing his work. Plus, a new airline is coming to town in Michigan's Upper Peninsula after a scary situation before takeoff where an emergency door flew off an aircraft. And later, produce problems are plaguing local farms. We'll hear from a farmer in Barnum who is getting creative to keep his crop alive.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 10.
Good evening, I'm Kristen Bakke. Thanks for joining us. He's known as a champion for the people of the Iron Range who doesn't back down from a challenge. Now, after a recent diagnosis, Minnesota Senator Dave Tomassoni is taking on a new one. We sat down with him as he shared his story and the message, no matter the obstacle, we're stronger than we might think.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Wow. After nearly 30 years in office, Senator Dave Tomassoni has some stories to tell.
Rick Avina walks up the wall so and puts his arm around him and says, see what you look like.
The Chisholm native turned professional hockey player turned state lawmaker has always had a knack for people skills.
You know, I was in the student council in eighth grade. You know, I was president of the class, and I sort of always just did it.
And eventually he found himself entering the big leagues.
An opening was available in one of the host districts because Jerry Janicich, who was the state rep, was running for state senate, and his seat opened up, so I ran for it and I won. And the rest of it is history.
A history centered around public service, as a few years in the Minnesota House led to decades in the state Senate.
I think I get the most gratitude personally from when an individual calls me and says, I'm having this problem. Is there any way you can help? And you make a phone call and it gets fixed. And it's actually pretty neat. And so I kind of like the personal relationships that you develop and the people you get to know.
It's those close relationships that give the senator comfort as he faces a new challenge, one that first started coming to light in December of 2020.
It started in my left hand, but I didn't know what it was. So for example, I would drop things, like I had a toothpick in my hand or something, I'd drop it, or a pen, and I would drop it. It's like, I don't know what that is. It must be this old age, right?
But then other things started to happen, like difficulty swallowing, uncontrollable emotions, and muscle loss.
I was dealing with a real lot of things as I was going through the legislative session, especially getting up on the floor and trying to talk. And so I was aware that there was something. I just didn't know what it was.
That is until early June when his doctors diagnosed him with ALS, or Lou Gehrig's disease.
Initially, I didn't want anybody to know, but you can't keep things secret in small towns, though. As I thought about it, I said to myself, it doesn't make any sense to keep it a secret. It's way, way bigger than me, and if I can help, let's do it.
That can-do attitude is something Tomassoni has leaned on during his time in office, and he says it will help during this new chapter.
When you develop relationships, first of all, and then you develop know-how, and you're able to make things happen as a result of it, it's kind of like you sit here and say, yeah, maybe I should keep doing this, because I think I got a lot to offer yet.
A sure sign his work here isn't done.
What I'm experiencing right now is a temporary pause in some of the things that I've been able to do, but I don't feel sick. And so, since I don't feel sick, I have no other way to approach it than I'm healthy. And so, I'm gonna just keep going at it from there.
Senator Tomasoni says he's feeling good and he plans to continue his work for the people of the Iron Range for the rest of his term, which ends next year. And at that point, he might run again. He's also working on ways to get involved with ALS organizations as an advocate. If you'd like to learn more about Lou Gehrig's disease and resources available, you can head to our website. Well, Dave is here for a first check of the weather. Dave, a few little raindrops for some folks today.
Yeah, really just a teaser, not exactly what we need. We need a lot more rain. Only one town seems to have gotten decent totals here today, while the rest of us received just a trace. So let's eye up what's come down since midnight as a low-pressure system slowly works through the region. Just a trace International Falls, Hibbing, Moose Lake, and Hayward, but Solon Springs at a little more than a quarter of an inch as a sign of what could potentially still come, as the low is only halfway done with our area. We take a look at the current Doppler map, and as that low and its cold front work through the region right now, we're in the warm sector of the low, which hasn't been paying off too badly, or too much actually, not too badly. 30% rain chance still tonight through portions of tomorrow, but then that cold front to the west will stir up a 60% chance for showers and storms Friday night into Saturday morning, and that may be the trigger for up to a half inch of rain. And that'll certainly help put a Band-Aid on the dry problem that we've had here lately. Here's our forecast for the short term tonight. Low temps will be around 60 degrees, 30% rain chance, as we mentioned. Then it becomes that 60% chance tomorrow night. Many towns in Minnesota and Wisconsin could go towards 85 tomorrow, but it may be warmer just a little bit to the south, and some folks are facing a heat advisory. I'll talk about who that is coming up in a few more minutes.
All right, thanks, Dave. According to a report from the Minnesota State Fire Department Association, the state ranks 48th in the nation when it comes to fire service spending. It's something our local departments say needs to change. And now a nonprofit is coming to the rescue. CBS3's Emma Quinn shares how new legislation will better support our hometown heroes and what that means to them.
Fighting the flames and sounding the alarms. Minnesota firefighters are set to receive more wellness support thanks to new legislation.
Actually, to a certain degree, a feeling of relief. There is some help. There is some light at the end of the tunnel.
On July 16th, the Minnesota legislature passed the Hometown Heroes Assistance Program.
It kind of covers three focus areas of cardiac, cancer, both care and prevention, and then emotional support.
Any career or volunteer firefighter who receives a cancer or cardiac diagnosis will now be given financial support.
Two or three of the folks that I've worked with in my career that have had to retire because of those illnesses.
It also provides mental health and wellness checkups for every firefighter and their family members.
Traditionally, you know, we were supposed to be tough, macho firefighters, whether we were male or female, and I don't think we always did that in the most healthy ways.
With the Hometown Heroes program now in play, firefighters will get the support they so often give.
The bill also supports training for mental health professionals to help them better understand the trauma firefighters might experience. The legislation was first proposed in February of 2020, but was tabled due to the pandemic. After 8 years of service, Lee Stewart has stepped down as the executive director of Churches United in Ministry, otherwise known as CHUM. And today, Community Action Duluth hosted a transitional party to pay tribute to Stewart and welcome CHUM's new executive director, John Cole. Cole talked about Stewart's good work in the community and how he hopes to further it.
Lee Stewart did a phenomenal job in responding to the needs of persons experiencing homelessness. I hope to build upon that by focusing on those persons who are experiencing homelessness but also have mental health challenges and substance abuse addiction problems.
The four main pillars of CHUM's mission are food, shelter, dignity, and hope. For more information on CHUM and how you can donate, you can head to our website. It has been 2 months since a door flew off a plane bound for Ironwood, Michigan, and now we're learning what's next for the airline. The current flight provider at the Gogebic Iron County Airport is Boutique Airlines, but the company requested to withdraw after an emergency exit door came off one of its planes before takeoff on a flight from Minneapolis to Ironwood. Today, the airport board listened to presentations from three airlines and, in the end, chose Denver Air to take over. The board wants to have a new airline providing flights out of Ironwood by October, but before that can happen, the decision needs approval from the federal government. The world's biggest 3D archery and music festival saw an energy-filled first day. Bowfest 2021 kicked off a long weekend of fun at Montelac Resort. The event features 60 archery targets, dozens of vendors, and live music until 2 a.m. Bridget Duffy of Montelac Resort told us there's something for everyone.
So Bowfest does revolve around archery. We have the four courses. We have the Organization of Professional Archery, with which is a money shoot, the OPA. But just a reminder that Bowfest isn't just for archers or people that are into bow hunting. It's for everybody.
13-time world champion archer Levi Morgan was in attendance at Bowfest today. Headlining the weekend's musical performances is country artist Travis Tritt. The event runs until Sunday, and for more information, you can head to our website. Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, as extreme drought conditions continue, local farmers say they're starting to feel the strain on their crops. How one is beating the heat, next.
Cooler than normal yesterday led to near normal today, upper 70s, warmer than normal tomorrow, with a heat advisory for some parts of our region, at least down to the south. We'll talk about who has to take it easy for about 6 hours, coming up right after our break.
CBS News Sunday Morning with Jane Pauley on CBS.
6-year financing has been extended at Home Furniture. Everything is on sale, and you can finance it for 6 years with no money down and no minimum purchase. Extended savings with 6-year special financing only at Home Furniture.
This is the internet that keeps the TV streaming, the meetings zooming, the playlist flowing, and the doorbell showing
anybody home?
Who's coming and going. This is the internet that powers the workout, that does the homework, that makes the lights work, that makes for light work, and makes...
Don't forget to pick up Charlie.
Your life work. This is the internet that keeps it all connected and has hundreds of people who ensure it's protected.
Nice try, hackers.
This is the internet voted best because it's extreme, nothing less.
If you're worried about spoiling your dinner with any of our dollar sliders from 2 to 5 p.m. at Arby's, do what I do. Order a dollar shake to take your mind off it. Arby's, we have the meat.
Mopping the dirt from your floor is a messy chore. Well, now you can spin away those germs with Floor Police, the lightweight and cordless power spin mop that scrubs away messes the fast and easy way. Just add any disinfectant, and at a speedy 100 RPMs, the microfiber pads do all the scrubbing so you don't have to. The secret is the powerful electric motor and rechargeable lithium battery that has 90 minutes of runtime. The swivel head can easily clean in and around obstacles and get deep under furniture. Plus, the pads are machine washable and reusable. Get Floor Police with two microfiber pads for just two easy payments of $29.99. But wait, call now and get two free scouring and two free polishing pads. But hold everything, because you can double the entire offer. Just pay separate fee, and we'll even ship it to you free. That's two Floor Police mops with pads, plus free shipping on your entire order. Call or click now.
Call 1-800-592-0163 or visit floorpolice.com. So call 1-800-592-0163 now.
After a year or two of experiencing brain fog and weight gain and sadness, I decided to come to Novus Health Solutions and have hormone replacement therapy. Life is no longer a chore. I have my life back. It's the best thing I've ever done.
Test rest, then buy a famous purple mattress now at Home Sleep Express. Plus, get no money down, 6-year financing with free delivery, free setup, and a 120-day guarantee. It's so science-y. The famous purple mattress now at Home Sleep Express.
CBS 3 Weather is brought to you by Lulich Implement.
New data out today shows Minnesota's drought conditions are quickly getting worse. The latest U.S. Drought Monitor shows 72% of Minnesota is currently experiencing severe drought. That's up from just 52% last week. NPR News says the news is startling, since at the start of June, not even 1% of the state had severe drought areas. The more intense extreme drought category is also expanding, up from 4% last week to almost 19% this week.
Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
past couple of days, we were cooler than normal, which was a break from last weekend's warm spell. Now we're getting back towards normal. Tomorrow, we're going to start to be warmer than normal again, and humidity levels will increase, perhaps to uncomfortable zones. And that's leading to a heat advisory then just to the south of our area. Tomorrow for Pine County in Minnesota and Burnett County in Wisconsin, a heat advisory will be in effect from 1 to 7 p.m. Heat indices could be near 100 degrees. Not quite that hot for the rest of our region, but still warmer than normal. And we'll hold on to warmer than normal conditions for several days. This will come on the heels of a rain chance, which didn't pay off much today, but has a better shot tomorrow night into Saturday morning. And as tomorrow night unfolds, we may fire up some severe thunderstorms, so we'll have to watch out for that. Current conditions at the airport, 66 degrees for the temp, 87% for the relative humidity, with an easterly wind running 10 miles per hour. 30.04 inches of mercury is our barometric pressure. And current temperatures will start north and work south this time. Still 78 International Falls, but only 68 for Eveleth, Virginia, and the Quad Cities. We have 66 in Hermantown, 64 Cloquet, and a hair warmer that in Moose Lake. Up the North Shore, temperatures are running in the 60s, and for much of Wisconsin, we have 60s along the South Shore, 65 in Superior, for example, but it's still as warm as 72 in Solon Springs and pretty close to that in Hayward. Upper Peninsula numbers are going 69 to 73. Overnight lows tonight likely will be upper 50s through the mid-60s, and then again tomorrow, daytime high temps, actual air temps could run 85 to 90, so the heat is back on. And there is a rain chance running just to the south of our area, just south of Rhinelander, not quite touching our area. Earlier today, yeah, we did have a few sprinkles, a couple of isolated thunderstorms popping off from the front end of a low-pressure system working through our area. Tomorrow, the backside of the low comes through. This cold front stirring up a 60% chance for showers and storms Friday night into early Saturday morning. And like I mentioned, thunderstorms are possible, and some of them could become severe. So we'll have to keep an eye to the sky tomorrow night and hope that when a cumulonimbus cloud does come to call, that it drops a fair amount of rain here for our region. As we get into the weekend, higher pressure comes in behind the departing low, and we become sunny again, and we become warm as a warm front works on through our area. So if we get the rain from the back half of this low by Saturday morning, hopefully totals are going to be something we can use to solve these drought problems, or at least ease them a bit. Latest indications are about a quarter of an inch to a half inch for a lot of towns, and we can see towards the UP we might even get a little bit more than that. So let's pin our hopes on this, and hopefully it pays off, because for the weekend we are going to be dry again. Tonight in Minnesota, 30% chance for some rain. Not a great chance, but better than nothing. 58 to 65 for the low temps. 30% chance for rain will be shared with Wisconsin and the UP. And low temps there, probably 63 to 66. For tomorrow, there's the warmth coming back. 85 to 90 for Wisconsin and Michigan. 70% chance for those overnight storms into Saturday morning. 60% for Minnesotans to get that, with inland highs 85 to 90 and 75 to 80 closer by the lake. And with the extended forecast, we can see that these warmer temperatures are now with us for the rest of the week. Staying sunny from Saturday through Monday. Next chance of rain could be with us for Tuesday and Wednesday. Right now, it looks to only be 30% chances, and no indication yet on the models if they'll pay off with much precipitation. But since we're so short, well, we'll be hopeful for that event as well.
We sure will. Thanks, Dave. It's an increasingly tough summer for northern Minnesota farmers thanks to that drought. And maybe the biggest sign yet of those struggles, a downtown Duluth farmers market was called off for the season because farmers have little produce to sell. CBS3's Natalie Grant spent the day on a farm in Barnum to learn more about the challenges many are facing.
Summertime in the Midwest typically means more access to fresh produce. Not this year.
It was a tough decision, but one that we felt we needed to make for both our vendors and our attendees.
Shanda Hansen with the Greater Downtown Council says Thursday's decision to cancel their downtown market was in large part due to the drought causing poor growing conditions.
It's kind of at a tipping point now, and if we don't get rain soon, they're going to just lose a lot of their crop, and yields are already suffering for sure.
John Stoltz with Sprouted Earth Farms in Barnum sells his crops at the Duluth Farmers Market's main location. And while many are struggling, Stoltz says his crops are faring well this year due to an irrigation system delivering water straight to their roots.
We just made that a priority when we first set up, is to make sure that we have irrigation set up for everything so that if it ever is an issue, we're prepared for it.
But no matter the plans, the growing drought still weighs heavy on the minds of every farmer.
Yeah, the lack of the water is a problem, but it just takes a toll on people mentally. It's a lot of stress just worrying every day whether or not how much longer it's going to be until it rains.
The GDC hopes to have the downtown market again next year. The main Duluth Farmers Market is still open every Wednesday and Saturday. Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, what would you do if you saw a fawn swimming in Lake Superior? How kayakers came to its rescue. Next.
Breaking news, original reporting, and the good things in life. Join Jeff Glor, Dana Jacobson, and Michelle Miller on CBS This Morning, Saturday.
Want to lose fat quickly? Lose up to 1 pound of fat a day.
My name is Keith. I'm on the Healthy Systems USA plan. Been on it a little over a month, and I've lost 25 pounds so far.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
We pick up the phone because it's ringing. Hello, this is Sam. That's simple human sense.
Ask J3 Insurance in Duluth if auto owners make sense for you.
Unlock a summer of possibilities in a new Chevy. Expand your options and your perspective. Find your next adventure in a new Chevy.
Make no monthly payments for the rest of the summer on all Silverado 1500 crew cab pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing for 72 months and get $2,000 cash allowance.
Mining, it's a part of Minnesota's history that affects everyone in the Northland still to this day. Join me, Kristen Bakke, every Tuesday for Eye on Mining.
Brought to you by Range Regional Airport. Watch Eye on Mining with Kristen Bakke every Tuesday at 10. Only on Live Local CBS 3.
Observe a domesticated human family in their natural habitat, known to their species as the backyard.
Hey, you think I should light it now?
I think it's good.
Yeah?
Oh dear, someone is about to burn a pile of debris that's too tall, which can start a wildfire. Wait, what could it be? Blimey,
oh,
it is.
It's Smokey.
It's Smokey Bear. What a legend.
Hey, it's Smokey. Sorry, it was too high.
Right. Watch as he astutely ensures that there's no wind and how he removes some of the debris to create a smaller, safer burning pile.
No, you can't make it bigger.
No, you can't make it bigger, baby. The bigger, the better.
Take note of our fearless furry friend here, humans.
I appreciate it. Fist bump.
Watching you.
Smokey's done it again.
Bye, Smokey.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
I have lost 25 pounds and I'm still going strong. Super easy. You follow the program and you lose weight. It's just that simple.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
Get your new John Deere tractor from Duluth Lawn and Sport, the region's largest power sports dealer.
This show is about connection. Not even 2020 and socially distancing ourselves are going to get in the way of that.
Are we 6 feet apart?
The Kelly Clarkson Show on CBS 3. CBS 3 Sports is brought to you by Northland Lawn Sport and Equipment.
Well, take a look at this. A group of kayakers came to the rescue of a fawn swimming out far into Lake Superior. It happened yesterday afternoon along Pictured Rocks National Lakeshore in Michigan's UP. Viewer video shows the group trying to rein in the fawn, who appears to be a strong swimmer even in the big waves. And thankfully, they were able to get the deer back to shore safely.
That's impressive.
It is impressive. I can't imagine that. Well, at least it was a fawn, so it was they're a little smaller to grab, but I'm sure it was just going nuts.
I don't know how much endurance a little baby fawn would have.
No, thank goodness those kayakers were there.
I know. What a fun story.
Yes. Do you have a fun story in sports?
I have many fun stories, Kristen, let me tell you. It's 48 hours later, and the madness in Milwaukee is back in business for the epic championship celebration. And the cruise ship sailed to Tampa Bay in a big MLB trade. I Reel in Sports next.
Get your news on the go, the CBS 3 mobile app.
Dear Exit Strategy. All your pieces are in place. Always Toyota SUVs.
Right now, get $750 customer cash on many of your favorite Toyota models. Toyota, let's go places.
Mopping the dirt from your floor is a messy chore. Well, now you can spin away those germs with Floor Police, the lightweight and cordless power spin mop that scrubs away messes the fast and easy way. Just add any disinfectant, and at a speedy 100 RPMs, the microfiber pads do all the scrubbing so you don't have to. The secret is the powerful electric motor and rechargeable lithium battery that has 90 minutes of runtime. The swivel head can easily clean in and around obstacles and get deep under furniture. Plus, the pads are machine washable and reusable. Get Floor Police with two microfiber pads for just two easy payments of $29.99. But wait, call now and get two free scouring and two free polishing pads. But hold everything, because you can double the entire offer. Just pay separate fee, and we'll even ship it to you free. That's two Floor Police mops with pads, plus free shipping on your entire order. Call or click now.
Call 1-800-592-0163 or visit floorpolice.com. So call 1-800-592-0163 now.
At Novus Health Solutions, we offer long-term solutions for chronic conditions. If you are suffering from joint pain, weight gain, a mood disorder, hormone imbalance, erectile dysfunction, or low sex drive, contact Novus Health Solutions to find out how we can help you without the use of surgery.
Built upon a solid foundation of cast iron and steel, the Kubota L-Series tractor is the number one selling compact tractor in the U.S. for over 10 years. Powerful Kubota diesel engine, ease of operation, and your choice of a dependable Kubota gear or HST transmission. The durable Kubota L-Series tractor. Talk to your local Kubota dealer today to schedule a demo.
No one serves you better than Lurley Gentleman.
Breaking news, original reporting.
How do you hope to change the world?
And the good things in life.
Live music and variety.
Where are you going to get that?
Here.
Join Jeff Glor, Dana Jacobson, and Michelle Miller on CBS This Morning Saturday. Go to the ends of the earth.
Very pleasant place to be.
I couldn't ask for anything more.
And reach for the stars.
Where's the ask? This is great.
Do you still love it?
I do.
But wait, there's more.
Experience thought-provoking.
It was literally like Groundhog Day.
I do know what makes a good movie.
Innovative.
It's hard not to overflow.
And truly original reporting. Because there's always something new under the sun on CBS Sunday Morning.
Dear Exit Strategy. All your pieces are in place. Always Toyota SUVs.
Right now, get $750 customer cash on many of your favorite Toyota models. Toyota, let's go places.
A parade party that has been five decades in the making. And it was a quick turnaround, but the Bucks managed to pull off a massive championship celebration in downtown Milwaukee. Less than 48 hours removed from beating the Suns in the NBA Finals, they held a parade today. Even Hong from our sister station WQOW was there to soak in the monumental Milwaukee madness.
Nah, say how y'all doing,
The party goes on in Milwaukee. The Bucks are the 2021 NBA champions, and Milwaukee fans showed out to celebrate with the team one more time.
Bucks in six. Come on, Bucks in six.
Governor Tony Evers was on hand for the celebration after declaring July 22nd Bucks in six day. He still got a mixed reaction of cheers and jeers. No jeers for Mike Budenholzer, whose three-year championship coaching process paid off.
I couldn't be more happy for our players, for our team, for our organization, for our city of Milwaukee, NBA champions. Yeah!
PJ Tucker was feeling himself. His dog mentality carried over to the rest of the team this year.
We got balls, Jimmy! We got the balls!
Fan favorite Bobby Portis was embraced by the city this season, and he returned the love.
You know, without you guys, we wouldn't have got this done. And shout out to the best fans in the world. Appreciate y'all.
Drew Holiday completed the championship puzzle in one season after 7 years with New Orleans.
And in 1 year, man, look what we could do. Maybe we could do it again, huh?
It took 8 years for Chris Middleton to get his ring in Milwaukee. He says it was a long time coming.
Struggled, went through a lot of, you know, just ups and downs. Well, we finally got the job done for sure.
And the only accolade the Greek Freak was missing was a ring. He brought it to the city where his NBA journey started.
Milwaukee, we did it, baby! We did it!
beat him. It's unbelievable.
Giannis stayed in Milwaukee for one reason, to give this city an NBA championship, and the fans showed out the only way they know how. From Milwaukee, I'm Evan Hong.
Organizers estimate that there was 100,000 fans downtown for the Game 6 win on Tuesday. And through the heart of their city, a similar amount of Bucks fans recreated a sea of green and white along the parade route. And in the Deer District, for the official celebration, the Bucks capped off their parade party in a storm of champagne showers and confetti. It is official. After making a name for himself in Bulldog Country and erupting the NHL as a force to be reckoned with for the Wild D-line, defenseman Carson Soucy is trading his Minnesota roots and planting new roots out west after three seasons with Minnesota. The Seattle Kraken selected Soucy in the NHL expansion draft on Wednesday night. The 26-year-old defenseman will continue his career as a part of the league's newest franchise. The selection of Soucy leaves the Minnesota Wild shy of two defensemen. Currently, Jonas Brodin, Matt Dumba, and Captain Jared Spurgeon represent the Wild's blue line. Wild sure have holes to fill, and specifically big shoes to fill after the Western move from Soucy as Minnesota heads into the NHL free agency next week.
It obviously stings. You know, Carson's a great kid. You know, a player that we had saw a lot of value in. His progression over the last couple of years was fantastic, and we wish him nothing but the best. He gave us some good years, and he's going to do fantastic.
Soucy played 108 games for the Wild and scored 8 goals and 31 points. With the MLB trade deadline just 8 days away, it looks like the Twins have made their first big move. Minnesota is sending slugger Nelson Cruz to the Tampa Bay Rays. They're getting a pair of minor league right-handers Joe Ryan and Drew Strotman in return. The Twins are also sending minor league pitcher Calvin Frotcher to Tampa in the deal. Meanwhile, the Twins are hosting the Angels. Los Angeles has dropped its last 3, and the Twins were 1 run from extending their losing streak, but Twins dropped today 3-2. And that's a wrap for sports. We'll be right back after the break.
CBS 3 Closed Captioning is brought to you by Essentia Health Pharmacies. Keeping things safe, simple, and convenient through mail, local delivery, drive-through, and curbside pickup services.
Hi, I'm Deb. By April 2016, I had lost 85 pounds. It was a very easy program to do. Blood pressure has gone way down. I feel great.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
Welcome to Medical Insight, a weekly healthcare feature brought to you by the experts at Essentia Health. Here's your host, Louis St. George.
Today on Medical Insight, Dr. Ann Simmons talks about the importance of Essentia Health's neonatal intensive care unit.
The NICU is a specialized intensive care unit where we take care of premature babies as well as babies who are born with unexpected health problems. Babies have very unique medical needs, and it takes a very specialized group of care providers to be able to give them the care that they need. We're very fortunate to have many pediatric subspecialists here at Essentia, and so we can provide the specialized care that they need. For example, we have pediatric cardiologist, endocrinologist, pediatric, you know, neurology, gastroenterology, many services that can support us to provide the full specialized spectrum of care for our tiniest pediatric patients.
Essentia has the only NICU in our region.
We have a dedicated transport team where we fly helicopters and drive ambulances all over the place to bring sick newborns to receive care here at Essentia. A lot of families feel a pretty strong connection to the NICU after their babies go home. You know, they've had, you know, the same bedside nurse for you know, months, or, you know, we have a fairly small group of physicians and providers, so we make a really strong bond and connection with them. My favorite part about my job is seeing these babies in NICU follow-up clinic when they're toddlers and, you know, growing up and thriving.
Additional support for families of Essentia's tiniest patients includes a 5-room Ronald McDonald House. For Medical Insight, I'm Louis St. George.
This Medical Insight was brought to you by Essentia Health. To learn more, go to EssentiaHealth.org.
Want to lose fat quickly? Lose up to 1 pound of fat a day.
Started my weight loss journey with Healthy Systems USA Easter weekend. By the end of October, I have lost 92 pounds.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
Well, Dave, we saw a few sprinkles today. Are we going to see any more?
Yeah, a few more sprinkles are possible tonight, parts of tomorrow, but a better chance of rain hits us tomorrow night into Saturday morning. 60 to 70% chance for showers and thunderstorms. Getting warm again. This two-day cool spell is now giving way to a long, warm spell. High temps 85 to 90, perhaps, from Friday all the way through next Thursday.
All right. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow.